students. Students, can you hear me? Students, can you hear me? Yes. Okay, so from here I think the problem is here only, but just we will start and we will complete it today. So breathing in, other for respiration in. Animals. So already we have learned about the insects, then about the earthworm. Then the frog. So insects have spiracles and they both respire with the skin. Okay, and next is the frog. The frog and the earthworm respires with the skin. The last one is the fish. So fish respires with the help of gills. So you can see here. Fishes, they are having an operculum like this. इसके नीचे यहाँ पर अंदर ऐसे फोल्ड, सो मेनी फोल्डेड स्ट्रक्चर इज देयर लाइक दिस विच इज कॉल्ड एज गिल्स. दोज हू आर ईटिंग फिश दे कैन सी दिस इज द ओपनिंग. एक ऐसे छोटा सा ओपनिंग होता है यहाँ पर जस्ट लाइक एन ईयर. इफ यू सी दैट okay, if you see that reddish color branched structure you can see, and this is nothing but the gills. Okay, so this is the gills. Is it clear to all students? Is it clear? Okay, now how do the fishes they breathe? So what they do is they take the water through the mouth. The water reaches here to the gills. The gills, they absorb oxygen. So the gills absorb oxygen. What is the function of gills? They absorb oxygen. So they absorb the oxygen, and here in this way the gills they absorb the oxygen, and oxygen is provided or oxygen is supplied to the whole part of the body. So students, have you understood now? Yes, absorb the oxygen through water, because water is having dissolved oxygen. Water contains dissolved oxygen. Water is having dissolved oxygen. Water is also having dissolved carbon dioxide. So it can take the oxygen from the water. Understood now? And this is only the reason why the running water, mostly the running water, or we can say the river water, contains more amount of oxygen, because as the water is running, or as we can say that the molecules, they come to the surface, they absorb more and more oxygen. Is it clear to all? Understood, students? So now, also in the fish pond, you might have seen that they place an aerator in the fish pond. Wherever the fishes are there. So here you can see that one machine is there and the bubbles come out. Adding a plug here. So these aerators in the water produces the bubbles. Bubbles are produced. These bubbles are nothing but it provides the air to the water, and air means the oxygen that is provided into the water. So in this way, when the fish pond is kept inside, or if we are having the fish pond, a sufficient amount of oxygen is dissolved in that. For that purpose only we are keeping the this machine that is called as aerator. So it creates the bubbles, and now here you can see that with the help of these bubbles, this pond gets air and oxygen both. So here, have you understood now how the that is the reason why all the time we are thinking that fishes are eating something. No, they are not eating. They gulp the water, and through the water they take the oxygen. They are gulping the water, and the water here reaches the gills, and the gills absorb the oxygen, and water here comes out through the gills. Water with carbon dioxide, it is coming out. So oxygen is absorbed, and water with carbon dioxide is given out. Okay, so Jayan, your question is that oxygen is there in the water, so we can't, why we can't breathe? The reason is that we cannot take the water. Our lungs are meant only to absorb the oxygen. वो वॉटर को नहीं एब्सॉर्ब कर सकता है ना. अगर वो वॉटर को एब्सॉर्ब करेगा तो क्या होगा, द सेल्स दे विल बी ब्लॉक्ड, द सेल्स विल गेट ब्लॉक्ड बिकॉज ऑफ द वॉटर, एंड दैट इज द रीडिंग रीजन व्हाई व्हेन अ पर्सन इज ड्राउनिंग और व्हेन द पर्सन ड्राइव्स इनटू द वॉटर, इफ ही इज अनेबल टू ब्रीद, देन इफ द वॉटर इज टेकन इन द लंग्स, so the person will die. Suddenly the person dies because the lungs, they are choked. Beech mein pani aa jata hai aur water oxygen supply nahi ho payega. If oxygen supply is not there, then a person dies suddenly. So jo pani mein doob kar jo mar jate hain, bilkul jaldi mar jate hain, unko samay nahi lagta hai. Understood now? यस बिकॉज लंग्स लंग्स के जो सेल्स है दे आर ओनली मेंट टू एब्जॉर्ब द ऑक्सीजन नॉट टू एब्जॉर्ब द वॉटर नाउ आर यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग स्टूडेंट्स ये समझ में आ रहा है क्या आपको Yes, Alice, what do you want to say? The oxygen in the water cannot be Yes, I am not getting Alice. What is your question? Oxygen in water can't be broken down by physical means. No, it can't be broken. How it will be broken? उसको कैसे broken? Means, I am not understanding what you want to say. आपका question मुझे समझ में नहीं आ रहा है. Alice, if you want to ask, you can simplify and ask again. What do you mean to say? ये इतना आपको समझ में आ गया क्या? See actually these fishes they are having gills and gills are very much expert. These are the organs which can absorb the water और water में से oxygen को एब्जॉर्ब कर लेते हैं मतलब पानी में जो ऑक्सीजन है उसको एब्जॉर्ब करने का जो स्पेशलिटी है हम कह सकते हैं वो गिल्स में है नॉट इन द लंग्स अंडरस्टूड स्टूडेंट्स नो नो ऑफ कोर्स गिल हमारे लंग्स अलग है और ये अलग है इट इज टोटली डिफरेंट Yes, no, Alice, actually it can't be broken, it can't be broken down like that, okay, because see, water as we know that in 6th class also you have said water is a universal solvent, that means water can dissolve so many substances in it, isn't it, it is a universal solvent. तो इसीलिए उसको यूनिवर्सल सॉल्वेंट कहा जाता है बिकॉज इट इज द लाइफ इजंट इट सो मेनी एनिमल्स लिव इन वाटर एंड लाइक दैट ओनली वी हैव आल्सो यू कैन सी दैट ऑक्सीजन कैन बी डिसॉल्वड इन इट कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड कैन बी डिसॉल्वड इन इट एंड दिस ऑक्सीजन ओनली व्हिच इज डिसॉल्वड इन वाटर कैन बी टेकन इजीली बाय द एक्वेटिक एनिमल्स एंड दैट इज द रीजन व्हाई एक्वेटिक एनिमल्स दे हैव गिल्स Mostly the aquatic animals they have gills, isn't it? Fishes जो हैं उनको gills होते हैं, जो amphibians होते हैं, when they are living in water, they also possess the gills. So gills, if they are having that means gills can absorb the oxygen from the water. It gets diffused. Understood now? Is it clear to all? Now is it clear? So this is how the fishes they breathe. They first gulp the water और जो पानी वो पीते हैं उसी पानी के अंदर ऑक्सीजन होता है The oxygen gets absorbed by the gills. These gills absorb the oxygen. Okay? And the rest of the water is given out. इसी में से यहीं से पानी को निकाल दिया जाता है गिल्स के थ्रू ये ऑपरकुलम है ये जो पार्ट है कवरिंग दैट इज कॉल्ड एज ऑपरकुलम So yes, have you understood now? Yes, all the water animals, aquatic animals, they have gills. Aquatic animals have gills. Then mammals, they don't have. There's a whales and dolphins and they don't have gills. That is why they come to the surface and they breathe again and then they go. इसीलिए वेल्स में भी ऐसे होल्स होते हैं. वेल्स का जो ये है यहाँ पर दे आर हैविंग होल्स, सो द वाटर इज गिवन आउट लाइक दिस. ओके, अंडरस्टूड स्टूडेंट्स? सो इन वेल्स दे आर हैविंग So, aquatic animals, they are having gills. Lekin sabhi aquatic animals, see, all the animals are not fishes. Dikhte hain fishes jaise. For example, whale. Whale is not a fish. It is a mammal. Dolphin is also a mammal. Understood? Woh sirf fish ki jaise isliye hai because it lives in the water. That is why the body is. These fishes, they cannot breathe like other fishes. They are not going deep into the water. They come to the surface again and again for breathing. They come to the surface for breathing. Understood, students? Turtle is not a fish. Turtle and tortoise, other these things, they are reptiles. वो fish में नहीं आता है, वो reptiles हैं. And reptiles only for few period only they go into the water. Okay, means not the whole life they are living under the water. They are not living under the water. Understood, students? Yes, octopus have gills. कुछ कुछ छोटे जो मॉलस है या फिर छोटे एनिमल्स है, they are also having gills. Okay? Yes, video is buffering from here itself, from my side also. Yes, fishes, they have gills. Yes, jellyfish is not a fish, I think. It is not a fish. See, because from here also I can see my video, it is interrupting between. Okay, it is not clear and not it is interrupting also, but anyhow today we have to complete this, so I am trying to complete all this. So this is all about the fish. Then last, about the plants. So now about the plants, how do they breathe? So first of all, about the roots. This is the root. The smallest branch is the root here. So root hair is very, very thin. Understood? Root hair. See, Mahalakshmi crocodile is not having gills. Crocodile is a reptile. It is not an amphibian. Okay. So, root hair has the capacity to absorb. So, यहाँ पर ये जो water molecules हैं, वो they are getting absorbed by the process of diffusion. पहले हमने देखा था this cell they are very thin and this cell are capable of diffusing the that is diffusing the water molecule from the soil. Yes, so leaves, though all of us know that leaves are having stomata, so they exchange the gases through the stomata. So leaves are having, if we see, so here at the under surface they are having these small openings. If we see under the microscope, so you can see this kind of structure. So this opening is called as stomata, and these are the guard cells. The guard cells, they are kidney shaped, which make the shape of the opening, and they are responsible. These guard cells, ये जो kidney shaped है, ये guard cells हैं. They are responsible for closing and opening of the stomata. So the leaves, they take oxygen, they give out oxygen or carbon dioxide through the stomata. The exchange of gases takes place through stomata. The leaves ke bare mein ho gaya, roots ke bare mein ho gaya. Now the stem, next part is the stem. So stems are having small pores. They are also called as lenticels. These cells also can absorb oxygen. Okay, so they are lenticels which absorb the oxygen. They give out carbon dioxide. So this is regarding the plants. So students, have you understood? So here we have completed. I will be sending you the PDF. Okay, students, I will be sending you the PDF of question answers. Start revision. And also do the revision at home. Yes, stem I will explain once again. In stem also the pores are there, small pores. These four are products, lenticels. And through these lenticels, the stem also can take the oxygen. Actually, the stomata helps to take the oxygen and carbon dioxide. The exchange takes place through stomata only. It is enough for the plants. But still, sometimes few pores are also present on the stem. And they help. If they require, they can also take the oxygen through these lenticels. Okay. Yes, students, attendance link I have sent, so you can just go through that. Yes, thank you, students.